top 25 matchup is on the docket down in Dixie for the Flames this week. Saturday, number 16 Liberty travels to face number 5 Jacksonville State in Jacksonville, Alabama. A year ago in Lynchburg, Jacksonville State downed Liberty 48-19, the worst home loss for the Flames in a decade. It's a night the Flames haven't forgotten.
We definitely have a lot to prove. These guys are a very deep, talented football team. Obviously, we saw that last year with these guys, and they have a lot of SEC transfers and a lot of guys who have a lot of talent who can play at the next level. So we're very excited about the opponent that we have this week.
Going in, we're going to know more of what to expect, like who we're playing against. So we got a better understanding of how the offense is. Obviously, vice versa, the offense know how the defense is. So we should be more prepared, like knowing who we're playing.
You know, it's a great football team that we're getting ready to face. But last year was last year, and, you know, we got to move forward from that.
In many ways, the Flames have moved on since that September night. Liberty is 3-0 for the first time since 2008. And the Flames now have one of the top offenses in the country, averaging 49 points and 536 yards per game.
Last year we went into the ball game, we were still trying to figure out who was the quarterback. So we played both quarterbacks, and so I think there was some inconsistency there. So we're all a little bit different in that we're pretty much settled in where we're at as far as who's playing what position, and not just the quarterback position, really all positions. We pretty much got our guys who are our top guys.
Jacksonville State has since continued its dominance. The Gamecocks have won 32 straight regular season games against FCS opponents. JSU is one of only two FCS programs with at least 10 wins in the last 4 years. The other is North Dakota State. JSU's defense has been a big part of that. The Gamecocks have held 19 teams to less than 100 yards rushing since 2014. That includes the Flames, who were held to just 44 yards on the ground last fall.
I just remember them being a fast, physical football team. They're coached up very well, and they have, like I said, they're very athletic. They have a lot of athletic guys on that side of the ball. And, you know, as for me as a player, that's something that I always want, you know, having to go against the best guys every single week.
Certainly last year when we played these guys, they did a really good job of defending the run. These guys don't give up much. You know, they're going to make you earn every single yard you get down in and down out week to week. And so there's going to certainly be situations outside where we're going to have a one-on-one situation in which we got to make, you know, we got to make the most of it.
The Flames defense will have a big test as well. Jacksonville State did lose All-American quarterback Eli Jenkins, but running back Rock Thomas is back for his second year. The Auburn transfer ran for 111 yards and averaged 8 yards per carry against the Flames last year. No doubt, number 6 will have a lot to do with JSU's game plan.
I mean, he's just, you know, a special type of athlete. You know, he came from Auburn, you know, SEC team. So, you know, he's, you know, one of the premier running backs in the country. And for us to be able to stop him, we just got to, you know, rally to the ball. And if one man get there, just hold him up, you know, just let everybody, you know, get a lick on him.
You know, Rock is a very exceptional running back. Their receivers are still just as good. You know, they only played 2 games. And so I think with the quarterback, Bryant, they're still trying to learn him a little bit more. But he's very efficient. He did a nice job, in my opinion, in both games. And you know they're well coached. So they had a bye week. And so we know we're going to get their best shot because they're a very dominant team and they play very well.
Liberty and Jacksonville State will kick off at 7 p.m. Eastern on Saturday night at Burgess Snow Field in Jacksonville, Alabama. The Liberty Flames Sports Network from VWSC will have live radio coverage starting at 5:30. The game can be seen on the Ohio Valley Conference Digital Network. In Lynchburg, for the Liberty Flames Sports Network, I'm Nick Pierce.